Hello, this is the RPG Chick. We've just absorbed the practical incarnation and leveled up in this place.
This is it.
This certainly is it.
Done.
At some point. We're going to talk to the paranoid incarnation now. We also have the good one to deal with, but let's get him over with. The man before you resembles you, but his back is hunched, as if he is perpetually afraid of being struck. He is watching you warily, and he hisses as you approach, his hands clenching, as if wanting to strangle you. His arms are horribly gnarled and scarred, as if they had been dunked into a stream of acid, and his left arm looks like it is holding on by a thread, literally. Who are you? Know that you will not last long in this place, thief. Spittle flies from the man's mouth, and his face twists in a maddening grin. Mazes and regrets and death are all that are here. What do you mean? You are a thief. The incarnation's hands twist as if wrapped around your neck. I will feel the bones of your neck snap beneath my fingers. Take my body back. You wear my body like a cloak, and you shame me. I am no thief. I stole nothing from you. You stole everything. I awoke on the streets of the Ring City, and all who saw me knew me. He takes a rasping breath. All that you had done, all that you had harmed, they were waiting for me, blaming me, hurting me, until I couldn't take the voices anymore. His fingers grasp at the air, and I had to make them silent. Which one? Trap in the sensory stone and the dodecahedron with the traps, or the one who killed the linguist Finn. You were the one who killed the linguist Finn, weren't you? Then wrote the dodecahedron journal in the language of the Uyo. He affixes you with a wary eye. It seems just looking at you is making him uncomfortable. You're the one who set fire to Ianis's legacies, weren't you? Trying to destroy my legacy? I burned the false papers, yes. More lies. Lies about my false lives. The sensory stone trap. You're the one who left it for me, weren't you? Yes. He smiles, low and evil. Simple trap. Trap for someone who can't die. Mind trap. It was simple to escape, actually. The smile freezes on the incarnation's face. You lie. No, it was pathetically easy. I was able to escape it with no effort. Lying thief. His eyes blaze like fires, and you watch as he clutches his left arm, then pulls, the stitching at the shoulder tearing off, unraveling. What? Oh, boy. Can I just try to talk to him instead?
Done. I'm hurt.
Yeah, I know. I haven't rested, and I have these spells still. Oh, I'm hurting both of them. Oh boy, this isn't good. I didn't want to hit the good one. Not a good idea. Run, will ya? Sheesh. mean to do that. Okay.
All right. Done.
Let's just run up here. See if we can get off a spell here. Can't get off a spell. When does he actually start using that? This one, move! I'm running out of these. I kind of don't want to go near the other one he's going to attack.
I'm gone.
Ah, oh, he's just keeping up. Let's not ask him those questions. How sad. You're the incarnation of Lady Mazed, aren't you? I found your journal in a lady's maze. Simple escape, simple trap. Broke her maze with ease, I did. I could have made it tighter, deadlier. He smiles. She knew nothing of what it takes to trap me. It seems so. There are other things I would know. You're to blame for killing the linguist Finn, aren't you? There. He seems confused for a moment. There are many that I killed. There were many that needed to be silenced. What happened to your arm? He glances down at his arm for a moment, then looks up and smiles. It kept coming off, so I had to stitch it up again. Do you know how I can leave this place? I will never tell you, and you will never leave. He smiles. It is quiet here. Peaceful. What do you know of the other incarnations? Thieves. They are thieves, all of them. And thieves will die. Alright, we worked our way through all this stuff. Except that. Language of the Uyo. Let us speak in private, just the two of us. As you speak the language of the Uyo, the incarnation's eyes widen, and he stares at you. After a moment of silence, he replies in the same language. Only I know the language of the Uyo. How do you know it? You are correct. You are the only one who knows the language of the Uyo. So, if I know the language of the Uyo, I must be you. Clever. He is silent, staring at you. It is these others who are not you, for they do not know the language of the Uyo. He nods, slowly. I hear you. This place confuses one's perceptions. We are both you, and now we must become as one. He looks frightened. To your surprise, he reverts to normal speech, and all the inflections to his voice are gone. It is calm, level, and much like your own. I no longer wish to live like this. You have suffered much. You were born into a world where nothing made sense, where strangers claimed they knew you. They blamed you for things you knew nothing of, and they tried to hurt you. He looks at you, and you watch as the incarnation loses its mad gleam, and his eyes become more like your own. Yes. I will protect you now. You will know peace, for that is all you ever wanted, isn't it? The incarnation relaxes at your words, his eyes dimming as he locks gazes with you. There is the faintest of whispers, and he falls to the black stones. With his collapse, you feel a crawling sensation in the back of your skull. Strength and constitution increase permanently, and 64,000 more experience. And there's a flood of memories, and strength, and emotions, and you steady yourself, dizzy for a moment. Then your vision clears, and you are yourself once more. Farewell. Alright, let's save here. To Incarnations. The man before you resembles you, but his face seems calmer somehow. He gives a slight smile as you approach, and he nods as if in approval. Are you all right? Who are you? Have we ever had a name, or was it just the first of us? The man chuckles softly. Know that I am your ally in this. I, like these others, have died my death in your mind, and the figment, this figment, is all that remains. But who are you? Ah. His smile fades, and he looks at you with concern. This must be disorienting for you. Let me try and explain. I am one of your incarnations. I was lost, once lost, now I am here again. How is that possible? I do not know. Whatever you touch within the fortress had brought pieces of yourself to the surface. He pauses for a moment, thinking, one of the others may know the means of how this came to be, but it is beyond me. If you are a part of me, there are things I must know. Ask. I have had countless lives. Why are there only three incarnations here? I do not know. Perhaps we were the three pieces that were somehow still present in your mind. Present? How? I do not know for sure, but I would guess that when we die, traces of the former personality may remain in your mind, and I know that sometimes we may make ourselves felt. How? When you're about to place yourself in danger or were close to a realization, for example, I found that I could stir, help prod you in the right direction. So you were that crawling sensation I kept feeling in the back of my skull? I would be at a loss to describe how it felt to you, but it is possible, yes. Before, when you said that when we die, traces are left in the mind, that's what caused you all to emerge, right? My understanding may not be complete, but yes, that seems to be the case, and we may make ourselves felt in small ways. So is it possible that the first of us, the real one of us, before all the incarnations, might still be buried somewhere in my mind? Nice. The expression on the incarnation's face flickers for just a moment, but is like a window, and you suddenly realize who it is you are speaking to. You were the first of us. The incarnation's eyes take on a haunted look, and his gaze turns away from yours. I know what you are thinking, but it is not the case. You think that knowing the mind of the first of us will somehow help you here, in this place. It will not. But why? I have so many questions that you can answer. Why did we become immortal? Why? I have a feeling we'll get to answer the other questions, maybe in a bonus episode. Because if we die, truly die, the incarnation looks up at you, and his eyes are like steel. Death's kingdom will not be paradise, not for us. If you spoke to these others that were here, know that a fraction of the evil of their lives is but a drop of water compared to the evil of mine. That life, that one life, even without the thousands of others, has earned a seat in the lower planes for eternity. But you seem so much calmer, more well-intentioned. I became that way, yes, because for me, his voice takes on a strange echo, it is regret that may change the nature of a man. He sighs, but it was too late. I was already damned. I found that changing my nature was not enough. I needed more time, and I needed more life. So I came to the greatest of the Grey Sisters and asked her for a boon, to try and help me live long enough to rectify all the damage I had done, to make me immortal. And Ravel did, but when she first tested your immortality and killed you, you forgot everything. Everything. He looks broken, and the planes have been dying ever since. The crime is great, and the blame is mine. There are so many questions I have for you. Who are you? What was your life like? Who? The incarnation shakes his head, cutting you off. When I become no more, when I merge with you, you will have the answers you seek. It may take some time to sort them out, but they are there. He smiles ruefully. It is difficult to communicate a life with words. Very well, then. We shall become as one. Are you ready? One last thing. Just this. The incarnation pauses for a moment, searching your features. Before I return to oblivion, there is something I would know. I can spare a little time for this. What do you wish to know? He studies your eyes, his expression somber. Did you live your life, the brief life you have had? In the end, was it worth it? It seems so short. What little I experienced, I enjoyed, and I do not wish to forget it. Wisdom increased permanently. 32,000 experience. He nods, and for a moment you think he's going to say something, but then he collapses, the life running out of him and into yours. As he falls to the black stones, you feel a crawling sensation in the back of your skull, making you shiver, and you know the incarnation is no more. Farewell. Dianara. Alright, I'm gonna keep this in stages here. Before you is the ghostly form of Dianara. Her spectral gown seems stirred by some ethereal breeze. Her eyes rest on yours, and you feel a strange disjointed sensation, as if you are looking at several pairs of eyes at once. Dianara? My love, at last I have found you. I searched for you after you were divided by the crystal. This fortress spans hundreds of miles, and I feared you were lost to me. Her ghostly eyes take your measure, searching your bodies for new wounds. Are you well? I think so. The crystal divided me, but I am one again. Now I am trapped here forever. I suspect trapping you here was the crystal's true purpose, but it poses no barrier for one such as I. She closes her eyes. Much do my eyes see, and the halls of this fortress are well known to me. If you are trapped here, my love, I shall see to it you are set free. Where is it you wish to go? I wish to speak to you for a moment and tell you how you died and why. What are you speaking of? Through truth. When I brought you to this fortress, it was my intention that you die here. I needed someone to remain behind so that they would serve as a link to this place. I knew because you love me so much that your love would stave off death and allow you to become a spirit, and that is why you suffer now. Dianara's face is a mask as you speak the words. truth. It was necessary, Dianara. I am sorry that you have suffered. Do you love me? If you say yes, my love, then nothing that has happened matters. Truth. Though I did not know you at first, I have come to love you. Your suffering has become mine, and I have found that I will do what I can to help you. Then I will aid you, my love. Tell me how I can help you, and I shall do it. I am trapped here. Can you help me escape? If you are trapped here, my love, I shall see to it you are set free. Where is it where you wish to go? I wish to rejoin my friends. As you wish, my love. She stretches out her hand. Touch my hand, and the walls of this fortress shall be walls no more.
I forgive what you have done.
If I were her, I don't think I would.
I shall wait for you in death's halls, my love.
Don't remember that. She said that in the beginning. I'm saving like this so that I can... What are we up to? 135, I think? Yeah. So I can easily do bonus content, go back and do other choices that... I want to see what happens if I lie to her or something like that.
Done.
Oh, I'm rejoining them. They're dead. Ray's dead. Well, who's who here? Is that... That must be Anna. I can't raise anybody. It won't show up. I can raise myself, but I'm not dead. Okay. Oh boy.
So you have come. Then you shall die again.
You're an ugly thing, aren't you?